Okay, what did you say? Make it more clear. That's really good. And it doesn't fit the picture because we don't really know for sure what happened. We just know, like the picture we looked at yesterday that you mentioned, where we had stuff folding up, and at the top, it was all worn off. And then something else was deposited. So yes, yes, exactly. Something that looks like it shouldn't be there. What about folded? When we think of folded, what do you think of? So was that where something like stuck up through the box? That looked like something was coming up through there. How is that happening? Just on the front? Folding, what do you see? Like, what do you see folding?
Yesterday there was magma coming up through the layers of rock.
So that was folded in? This is a bit push on each side and made it kind of curve. Okay, that would be a good fold. What about faulted? What do you think of when you see faulted? Yeah. There's a line where one piece moves and the other piece doesn't. They look like they should have fit together at one point, but they don't. They're just shifted. Intruded and extruded. Okay, good. And what's the difference between intruded and extruded?
So intruded would be it kind of would come up like this and stop, and extruded it comes all the way out.
Very good. What about eroding? What can we see from what does the mind with the eroding? And what's that look like? Yeah. Have you seen erosion if you were in probably third grade? Contact metamorphism. Sometimes you see a dark line, sometimes you don't see anything, and you have to be careful because in these pictures, it's not always drawn. You have to go, oh, okay. When it should take place often happens when there's a fault or when we have an intrusion or an extrusion of magma because of the heat and pressure that causes. So every time you see one of those things, look for contact metamorphism. And tilting, probably an easy one. Something tilts. Okay. You see this? It can tilt a lot or a little bit, but what was originally laid down as sediment that was flat, now all of a sudden, isn't anymore. What might cause that? It will be evident in folding usually. What might cause it? Sure. Often a fault, sometimes contact of one plate to another. So what are you going to do with your pictures on the next page? Okay, you got these guys. On another sheet of paper, you're going to write like profile A, and then you're going to describe in order what happened there to make this happen. So a separate piece of paper, you can identify the events in order of occurrence. The oldest event goes at the bottom and the youngest at the top. And you're also going to identify a principle for each of those. So it's when you have your principles out in front of you. So let's look at these guys, and I'll get you started a little bit, see if this will work. Move this so we can. So here we have profile A, and I just moved this so we could look at it. You can put your papers next to each other. So what we want to do is we want to start at the bottom with the first, very first thing that happened, okay? The very first thing that happened, if you look at your next page, you can have a key to what all these guys are, and this happens to be limestone. So here's what you would write, starting at the bottom. This is going to be the bottom of the part. You can also, if you'd rather, start at the top, but it's sometimes easier to start at the bottom when you think about that. So you're going to write at the bottom, you're going to say limestone was deposited. And then you're going to note which of those five principles it was. Which would it be? Get your list of principles. Is there another one? You can pretty well assume that they all started out horizontal at one point. So the big one here would be law of superposition. Because the limestone was deposited over something else. What had to happen next? This is our next layer. From your key, this thing. What does your next layer look like? Uh-huh. And what law would that be? Another superposition. See what you're going to be doing here? So you're looking at your paper, at your picture. You're using your key to identify the kinds of rock that was deposited. And then you are using your list of principles to identify. where you're going to start at the bottom, so you're going to have to leave yourself some space. You can discuss these if you would like. Is it something that you must do by yourself? This one, they just wants to say folder because they can only put folder on there. And what's this one we're going to talk to? Yeah, I guess some original. Yeah, that one's a pretty simple one. So you're getting the idea down of how you're going to be doing this. And finding the principles are probably going to be, you've got a lot of superpositions, and then I like the way they do that little hut or something at the top. I thought that's kind of cute. A lot of principles, and then there's one more other than superposition that you're going to have to see. Thank you. noticing how it got there as well. Siltstone was deposited, limestone was deposited. And a good clue for that is over here what kind of rock it is. So when you see something in the sedimentary rock category, it was probably deposited. These guys were probably formed from contact metamorphism. Okay. And then these guys were probably metamorphic. And you don't really have any obsidian or granite. That's a clue as to how they formed also. You want to make sure that you say not only what it is, but how it got there.
take a look and see how you're doing with these.
You would have said for this one to finish it up. Which time do we have left? Okay, so minutes look at this. So to finish this up, you had first limestone, and then you had siltstone, and then sandstone, and then shale, and then limestone, all deposited. Okay, so those were all superposition. And then you had folding, and then erosion. Both of those were cross-cutting concepts. So the folding happened first. You're only racing. What did you think was happening here? Did you not have folding, or did you have them out of order? Where was the confusion? Okay, so if erosion had happened before folding, that whole top layer would be gone. All this limestone would be gone, but it's not. So it probably folded and then the erosion happened. Okay. So that's what you're getting straight in your head, is how you're gonna determine that. Okay, for the second one, for B, you had a little bit more going on there. You first had dull stone at the bottom. You had dull stone, sandstone, shale, and breccia all deposited, and those were all superposition. Yes. Then, to get the next slant part, it tilted. You had tilting going on there. After it tilted, it eroded, and eroded is cross-cutting concept, cross-cutting relationship. Okay. After the erosion, the stuff with the slanty lines is rock gypsum, and that was deposited. And that created an unconformity between the tilting and the deposition. You would have an unconformity, and that would be cross-cutting relationship and superposition both going on there. Then you had some sandstone deposited, the little dotty stuff is sandstone. So that was superposition. Then you had the intrusion, which is cross-cutting, and then you had an extrusion, which is the volcano and cross-cutting. So clean up the first three before tomorrow, work on them tomorrow, and then I'll let you do the mastery questions on Friday for your work. And I'll give you paper copies of those if you prefer. We'll talk a little bit more about this. So we'll finish this up tomorrow. Get the first three straightened out as much as you can. And we'll talk about them tomorrow. Thank you.
These are asking real quick, Mr. Lee.
How is it recording?